During the meeting, the President of Russia, Vladimir Putin, briefed the African leaders on the genesis of the conflict in Ukraine and all the steps that Russia as a country has taken to peacefully end the conflict that he said has been made impossible by Ukraine and her allies. President Putin said the crisis in Ukraine was started by the Western allies of Ukraine who wanted to use the Ukrainian territory to destabilize and undermine the integrity and sovereignty of Russia by establishing military bases with an intention of destabilizing Russia, something that Russia could not accept. I know that you are sincerely interested in doing what you can to help achieve a just and sustainable solution to the conflict. And of course, we greatly appreciate your balanced approach, as well as the fact that you have not supported and do not support anti-Russian rhetoric and anti-Russian campaign. If that happened, we wouldn't be even having this conversation right now, of course. President Putin further informed the African leaders that whereas they were critical of the perpetrators of the COP in Africa, the Western countries facilitated a COP in Ukraine, which was the beginning of the current crisis in Ukraine. He added that whereas the African leaders emphasized that Russia must respect the principle outlined in United Nations Charter, Russia has not violated the UN Charter, but rather the perpetrators of the COP in Ukraine are the ones who violated it, just like they did in Iraq, Libya, Sudan, Syria, among others, but only apply the UN Charter when targeting a particular country.
You say, dear colleagues, about attempted coup in Niger, that we are against coup d'etat. I am in full agreement. We too are against coup d'etat. But the other problem that led to today's crisis in the coup d'etat in Ukraine in 2014, that specifically was an unconstitutional, armed and bloody state coup, which the Western countries actively supported.
President Putin assured African leaders that Russia has always wanted a peaceful settlement of the conflict in Ukraine, but it's the Ukrainian leadership under the influence of the Western backers that go against all the agreements they make. On behalf of the African Peace Committee, the South African President Cyril Ramaphosa said that the African peace conflict endured to talk to both the Ukrainian and Russian leadership last month with a view of getting a balanced view of the crisis because they hold a neutral position in the conflict.
We proposed that we would like the Black Sea Initiative to be implemented and that the Black Sea should be opened. And in that regard, we were saying, so that we are understood, we were saying we would like the Black Sea to be open to the world market. And we were not here, as we are not, coming to plead for donations for the African continent.
He said that the African continent prefers a peaceful resolution of the conflict for the sake of humanity, but also noted that the conflict had directly affected the African continent, leading to the shortage of supply of fertilizers and grains in some African countries.
The way we feel that we have a right to call for peace, because the ongoing conflict, as you heard during the course of the day, also negatively affects us as African countries. Security is concerned. The prices of our fertilizers have gone up. The cost of living in many of our countries have gone up. And we do believe that it is in the interest of humanity and the people, yes, of Russia and Ukraine, that there should be peace and this conflict should be settled in a peaceful manner.
Ramaphosa appealed to both leaders in two countries to embrace peace and negotiation to resolve the conflict. He emphasized that all their actions should be in line with the provisions of the United Nations Charter.
A number of us have taken various positions with regards to this conflict, but the main and key positions that all of us have taken is that this conflict should be resolved through negotiations, through dialogue.
After the meeting ended, the President of Uganda, His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, departed from Russia.